viewers, welcome you all to Life After Recovery. Today we are going to talk about hair transplantation. Hair transplant is a cosmetic surgery and therefore it is advisable to get this procedure done by a cosmetic surgeon only. Kukuna, Center for Aesthetic Transformation, renders all aesthetic and cosmetic services. As far as hair transplant is concerned, Kukuna carries out both hair transplant procedures, manual and robotic. Now let me introduce you to Dr. Sanjay Parashar, an internationally renowned plastic and cosmetic surgeon who will help you understand the hair transplant procedure well. So welcome Dr. Sanjay. Today we are going to talk about the hair transplant. So first of all, I would want to understand what is hair transplant?
See, hair transplant is a procedure performed for people who are suffering from baldness. And it basically means taking the hair or borrowing the hair from the back of your head and implant it into the bald area. That's the basic philosophy of hair transplant. Hair transplants are done in two different methods. One is called FUT, which is follicular unit strip technique, which is the gold standard and a very old procedure, which is still very useful. In that procedure, what we do is we take a piece of skin with the hair from the back of the head. And through that skin, we take out single hair under microscope and then we implant the hair into the recipient area. The other technique is FUE, which is follicular unit extraction. In this, you just take out one hair at a time and these hair are then transplanted into the front of the head.
And doctor, what do, who is the right candidate for the entire thing?
See, hair transplantation is for people who are balding. It is not for people who are just losing hair, or it is not for people who have thinning of hair or hair fall. When there is a bald patch, and most commonly, like you said, is the male androgenetic pattern of hair loss, where men often have receding forehead, they have bald patch in the crowns. So those empty areas are filled by hair grafting. So they are the right candidate.
Doctor, we have heard of robotic hair transplant. What does that mean?
See, hair transplant, there are different ways of doing hair transplant. And the most advanced technique is the robotic hair transplant, where the actual robot is performing the procedure under the assistance of the doctor. The robot comes and scans the head of the patient to look for good quality hair. Then it starts picking up hair from that area. Once that is done, then robot also helps us to design the hairline, how it would look on a person, what angle to choose, what density that person would require. That is all advised by the robot. Once that is planned by the robot, then we design the recipient site. Recipient site means where the hair grafts will be implanted. And that is done by robot as well.
And what does it mean by wrong hair transplant, doctor?
See, wrong hair transplant, hair transplant going wrong also happens. And there are both elements involved. One is the person or patient himself who actually leads the doctor to do things that is not possible. And the doctor himself or herself gets under pressure of that patient to perform that. Then the other thing about doing it wrongly is designing the hairline. There are people who would want, they would want to look like Anil Kapoor. They would want as low as possible, you know, to cover almost their head, even when they're at the 40s. But that's not possible. It needs to match the age. It also needs to match how they would age in future. When they look 40 or when they are 50 and 60 and having a very low hairline would not look natural for them.
Okay, doctor, so can we color these hair, like the ones you're talking about, the permanent hair transplant when we do? Can we go for the haircut and can we color the hair?
See, these are your own hair that is taken from the body. And once it is implanted, it becomes part of your body and it grows normally. So you could trim it, you can style it, you can color it.
So the regrowth will happen automatically?
It will still happen because the roots are still being inside and they have been accepted by the body.
What about the gray hair problem which normally people face?
The graying part will happen with the age.
That will happen with
the age? That will happen with the age. But if you see, the graying starts mostly in the front part of the head or the side of the head. The back of the head grays after a long period of time. So the when that head hair is transplanted in the front, it follows the same genetic coding that it has. So it would take long time before it starts turning gray. But it would turn gray. So that's the natural process of the body.
Doctor, what is the difference between graft versus follicle?
See, when we do hair transplantation, we are actually grafting. So grafting is taking the hair from the back of the head and implanting it into the front of the scalp. But the graft contains few things and they contain what you call follicle. follicle means it's a complete component of the hair. Mm-hmm. What you see is just the strand of hair.
Yeah.
But what it also involves is the shaft which is buried underneath the skin, which has a root. So a single follicle means one root, one shaft, one hair. Whereas a graft means a collection of follicles. So a graft may be just one root as well,
mm-hmm.
or it may be two roots with two strands, or it may be three roots with three strands.
Right.
It's very important for everybody to understand what is, how many number of follicles are used, which may means how many hair one can grow. One graft does not necessarily mean one hair.
Mm-hmm.
It may mean two hair, it may mean three hair.
Mm-hmm.
So if somebody is saying I had 2,000 hair grafted done, it means 2,000 grafts would grow maybe 4,000, maybe 5,000 hair, depending on number of follicles or roots there is inside the graft.
Doctor, is it a painful process or like anything you would like to specify?
See, it's done under local anesthesia.
Mm-hmm.
So there is an initial part of pain, you know, where injection is given to numb that area.
Mm-hmm.
But once it is numbed, there is no pain at all. During the recovery time, it can be slightly uncomfortable the first day.
Mm-hmm.
But
you cannot
after
touch
two
your
or three
hair.
Days, to just or to sleep on that, so they need some pain medication.
Mm-hmm.
But after 4 or 5 days, the sensation comes back to normal. They may have some sensitivity if they really press on that area.
Mm-hmm.
But once it is healed, within about a week time, then the pain is gone.
So for after how many days you feel absolutely normal, no pain, no nothing?
Usually the recovery is first 2 or 3 days, they have to take care of that area. There may be mild swelling, they may require some pain medication. Usually 3 days or 2 or 3 days later, they are physically fine to perform their routine work.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But it may be visible as small crusts on that area, so they may have to use hair cap to cover that area.
For the initial days.
Initial days.
Mm-hmm.
But 7 days, 8 days, it clears off and then they look pretty normal.
Okay.
Until the time when hair starts growing, which can take about 2 to 3 months to start growing. And it takes about a good 6 months, 8 months for the hair to fully grow.
So thank you so much, Doctor, for being here with us. Dear friends, I'm sure you liked the brief session of discussion on hair transplant. For more information, you can log on to the website of Kokona, that is www.kokona.ae, or call them on their toll-free number 800-36-2636. Wish you a very good day.